I wanted a matte carbon fiber looking finish. I didn't want it super shiny because, one, I didn't want it to be super distracting, but I wanted it to be kind of subtle but look carbon fiber. And I wanted to do it basically as quick as possible because that wasn't, you know, the paint part really wasn't my, you know, biggest interest. I wanted to get my racing set up and, you know, get to playing. So let me show you how I did it super fast and super easy with spray paint. And I'm going to show you some tricks you probably didn't even know about. So let's get started. I totally get it. You've probably seen the shelf liner technique, but I guarantee you haven't seen this next trick. This is awesome. What I'm gonna do is, I've got my shelf liner right here, but if you look really close, it's real bumpy and it's actually real like poofy. But this stuff is made out of a type of like styrofoam, rubber type stuff. So all you have to do is take a towel, put your towel on top of it, and then you take an iron, your normal household iron, you turn it all the way up as hot as it'll go, and then you press down. Do not try to do this directly on the shelf liner. It will ruin your iron. So this is one piece of shelf liner that I haven't done this to, and as you can see, it's like really bumpy. But then after you iron it, it gets much more flat. Flat side, and you put it on your project. It is helpful to line it up. The pattern looks better if it's aligned with your project. And I just go lengthways across it and just keep it pretty much in the same spot. Then when I tape it down, I stretch it just a tiny bit, and that keeps it super, super flat on my project. You want it as flat as possible. So that's why this works really well with flat projects, but is super challenging with anything that's not completely flat. What I'm actually doing is, while I'm painting it, I'm looking down at my project, and I want to see basically an even amount of paint on top of my shelf liner, and that way I know I've gotten a pretty good effect through there. And it's gonna be pretty even, because you will notice differences if it's not completely even. Carefully pull your shelf liner up from one corner. Believe it or not, you don't really have to wait for it to dry. But one thing you do wanna do is, as you pull it up, you wanna check, and if it's not good, put it right back down, and then it'll stay aligned and you can do a little bit more. But this turned out pretty good. Okay, this next step is really taking it to the next level, and it's gonna blow your mind. I'm gonna take some 60 grit or even coarser. I think 60 grit is pretty much pretty good for coarseness. And I'm gonna go sideways on my project. Do not do this in any other angle. It needs to be straight with your little rectangles. And what we're gonna do is, we're gonna put little scratches across our rectangles, and it'll look like little fibers. It's a really cool effect. Now what you're going to do is just take a little bit of water and a damp cloth, and you're going to wipe it down to get that dust off. And remember, it's enamel, so the water is not going to mix with it. It's not a huge deal. Well, obviously if it's dry. And then you get a really good idea of how well this works. As it cleans up the dust, it really darkens it down, and you get a chance to see what it's really going to look like. You've got several options at this point. I'm just gonna go to my clear, and I'm just gonna do one or two, you know, medium coats, but you can go pretty wild right here. If you use automotive clear, you can then polish it down. If you wanna do that with spray can clear, you can. That process is a little bit longer. I'll make another video on that. I haven't done one of those in a long time. But for this, I really just want a couple of medium coats and it'll look fantastic. Clear coat's amazing. It pulls the colors together. And it also hides your mistakes. that's pretty much it. I got a really good result, really fast, and I didn't have to spend a ton of time on, you know, setup or doing all the, you know, the intricate airbrush work. And I got a fantastic result. Just like I said, I wanted a matte finish. It turned out fantastic. And I hope you got something out of this video. Well, if you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.